Hey folks, Joseph A. Sabara here. I'm very excited that the new Peanuts series is going to premiere on May 9th, which is a Monday, on Boomerang. But not only that, but this Friday is Arbor Day, a day we help grow, save, and preserve trees. And that's what arbor means, tree. Yep, because not only will you plant trees in order for them to grow, but you can also plant your own garden here and there. So that way, you get to save a huge tree if it grows a lot higher, so you can actually have your own shade. Think about that. Anyway, Peanuts does have a special about Arbor Day, which is called It's Arbor Day, Charlie Brown. And while it's not one of the greatest holiday specials that Peanuts had to offer, but it was indeed known for being a dedication to one of the greatest composers, Vince Guaraldi. Has been best known for doing the theme, Linus and Lucy. But hey, you know, Peanuts wanted to come up with something special, and even though this is basically just another baseball special, kind of like Charlie Brown's All-Stars, because to me, they were a whole lot better than this one. But that's okay, because I know some of the scenes that they have in the special had later been played in other specials too, even on the Charlie Brown Snoopy Show. Because it's part of the Peanuts comic strips from Charles M. Schulz. So, anyway, let's get to the special. It stars Dylan Beach as Charlie Brown, Gail M. Davis as Sally Brown, Liam Martin as Linus Van Pelt, Sarah Beach as Lucy Van Pelt. I think they're both brothers and sisters. Well, who knows? Because they both have the same last names. Stuart Broadman as Pepper and Patty, Greg Felton as Schroeder, Michelle Mueller as Frida, Benny Dow as Rewan Van Pelt, Linus and Lucy's brother, and by the way, this is actually the first special where we get to see Rerun. He also does Pigpen as well, and Bill Melendez as Snoopy and Woodstock. With Marcy, Franklin, Violet, and Patty all have their silent roles. But, hey, at least they were there. It's created by Charles M. Schulz, a.k.a. Sparky. Does all the Peanuts comic strips, and is directed by Phil Roman. The special begins where we meet Charlie Brown and Linus, along with Linus's younger brother, Rerun, who's just about to get on to Linus's mother's bike. But she's decided to ride around, you know, doing some errands and all that. But she just lost 3 pounds, while Rerun just lost 5 because of fright. So basically, it's your typical day where Rerun is just chatting around, even singing the song, 98 bottles of beer on the wall, 98 bottles of beer. You take one down, pass it around, 98 bottles of beer on the wall. Then the next day, at Miss Otmar's class, Sally was about to give an assignment on Arbor Day, which, unfortunately, the whole entire class had made fun of her. Feeling so humiliated, she decided to go with Linus to the library just to study about Arbor Day, and just bring out some books, along with Snoopy and Woodstock, who just about to pick out some books on obedience dogs, which Snoopy started laughing hysterically. So hysterically that he winds up going into the printer, just printing out all the pages of the books, and accidentally put Woodstock in there until they both got kicked out at the library. So Linus and Sally are about to go on their journey to celebrate Arbor Day by printing out a garden. What they didn't know was that they're about to plant their garden inside Charlie Brown's baseball field. Even though Charlie Brown was about to have a baseball game with Peppermint Patty's team. Little did we know, though, that the entire Peanuts game was about to plant the entire garden inside the field and about to nickname him simply Charlie Brown's Field. And that's when Charlie Brown felt completely shocked when he saw the entire field already covered with flowers. Yeah, a huge tree that's inside his pitcher's mound. And there's even a scarecrow that was created by using a baseball cap and two gloves. Wow. So now that Pepper and Patty's team had arrived, they decided to play the game anyway. Which basically that's how the special turned out to be, where, it's between Charlie Brown's baseball team and Pepper and Patty's baseball team just teaming up in order for them to win. They were completely lucky. Yeah, there's even a plant that actually moves too, because it was about to attack Snoopy. And the fact that Pepper and Patty was already getting stuck with the tree that's in the middle of the pitcher's mound, so even she had trouble with it. Well, Charlie Brown was almost lucky enough to finally win the baseball game. Well, at least he tried until suddenly a rainy day had occurred, and that's what happens. So then the game has cut short while Charlie Brown is still on the pitcher's mound, already telling them that they're critters. So he actually stands on there while it continues raining, while Snoopy is just just swimming around, and then Sally is just rolling on her just rolling on a boat that she just made. And then she finally gave a report the very next day on Arbor Day. So I think at this point she finally got an A in her report. Until the end, when Pepper and Patty and Charlie Brown was just sitting on the tree, just talking about what was going on last time and how he apologized and how she apologized about what happened. And then Charlie Brown's just wondering if he'll ever win in anything. So hopefully he'll still get a chance someday. He accepts it, and Pepper and Patty just ask him, "Happy Arbor Day, Charlie Brown." So then the special ends. For an Arbor Day special, this had to be pretty weak. And it's a shame too, because there have been better Peanuts specials out there. This is just basically another baseball episode that we already saw in Charlie Brown's All-Stars and a couple others that follow after that. I mean, the only memorable thing about this special was we get to see Snoopy and Woodstock doing some crazy things, especially when they were at the library. Or even seeing a rerun just going onto the bike, but that was at the beginning of the special, seeing that this was the first time we ever get to see Rerun, which is Linus and Lucy's brother. And also, there was another funny moment with Snoopy was when he was about to hang the weeds inside the where the umpire is, which is inside the gate, and suddenly the weeds started going out of control and it's already attacking Snoopy. It happened again when he was about to already make a home run, and he was running into the next base, and he got caught, and he was out. And there was another good moment was when they have the scarecrow actually have the baseball already being caught by one of the gloves, and same here with the tree. Also, some scenes with them just planting the tree, and all the other gardens that they were doing, even though they were stupid enough to actually plant inside Charlie Brown's baseball field, since this is Sally's dumb idea. Yeah, but of course she had to do it just for an assignment that she has to do. That sucks for Charlie Brown. Even then, he almost won the baseball game after all this trouble, because he was lucky enough to cream Pepper and Patty's team, and that's what happens when it all gets interrupted by a rainy day. So. But the fact is, I'm glad that this special had been dedicated to Vince Guaraldi, because he is indeed one of the greatest composers of all Peanuts specials. Yeah, especially when he's been known for doing Linus and Lucy. And I definitely love the score that he has done, even though he had completed the whole thing, just a several hours before his death. So I'm glad to see that they dedicated to him, even though they had changed the end credits later on. So I guess if you have to find the CBS broadcast, which aired at the time, you'll see it, because it's not on the DVD I'm not so sure if it's on all the original VHS tapes, but who knows. Either way, this special could have been a whole lot better than this, and it shows. So I have to give this special a mixed review, because at least it had some funny moments here and there, but at the same time, it's nothing special. So there you go. So that's It's Arbor Day, Charlie Brown, and I give that 2.5 stars. I'm Joseph A. Sabora, and I'll see you later. Bye.